Hey guys, welcome to my channel, Realm of Ori. In this video, we will continue with Volume 18, Chapter 1 Walpurgis, Part 7. If you haven't watched the previous video or chapter, you can find the link in the description below. Before we begin, this video contains light novel spoilers. If you do not want to be spoiled, do not watch it. And, if you will continue, an additional disclaimer notice. So without further ado, let's get to the video. It was more difficult than I had anticipated to handle the situation as the other demon lords were becoming agitated. Anyway, I finally got back to the main point, but when I thought about it, the situation was pretty bad. I forgot to explain it, which is my fault, but I'm sure it's not an easy story to hear. So, nobody here is under the control of the Regalia Dominion? It's okay, angelic skills don't seem to have any effects on the person being controlled, but Regalia Dominion is a forced dominance, so the person's ego disappears and they act in a strange way. In any case, Veldora told me that he had been taken over because he and I were connected by a soul corridor. I see. Then, how did you set Veldora free? This question again? But I didn't want to be stupid and say, I ate him, then Seal San did a skill alteration. I had to lie because they weren't going to believe me anyway. It's the same as when Velgren San did it. Veldora got his own powers when he was in a fight. I guess the power of friendship made it happen. Their looks were painful. I know they're looking at me with a lot of suspicion, but I have to keep going with this explanation. Hey, I also fought Velzard pretty hard, but she didn't seem to be getting better, you know? Well, I guess it will depend on the individual. Differences between individuals, huh? Is it pointless? They are starting to wonder. What do I need to do? Even if they didn't believe me, all I had to do was tell them the truth. But if I did that, they would say, not only will they make you deal with all the individuals who are under control, but they will also dig deeper into the master's skills. Just what I expected. First of all, I can't explain how it works because Seal San did it, not me. I guess keeping quiet is the right answer after all. Enough already. You don't seem to want to talk anyway, so you must have done something strange. The Regalia Dominion poses no more threat than the Ultimate Dominion if you know when someone is in charge. The question is, how should we deal with them? Rumen has thought that it was better in the long run that we could tell the difference. Then she said we should talk about what to do with Michael and the others. I agreed by nodding my head. Instead of choosing who should deal with whom, wouldn't it be better to choose how to move when they attack? I agree. I don't think the enemy is stupid, so I don't think they'll try to spread out their forces. That's true, but aren't we pretty far apart? Or should we all gather in one place and be ready for the enemy to attack at any time? I don't think so. Correct? Guy seemed to agree with what I said. I, on the other hand, will defend my country. Leon and Rumenas won't want to leave their countries, and neither will Degruel and Milam. Milam's case is hard to tell, but the others are clear-cut. If that's the case, we should be ready to send help to any part of the country that gets attacked. Yes, indeed, I have to stand up for my country. In the worst-case scenario, we should think about leaving our territory, but only as a last resort. I agree, yes, and don't be afraid. Without hesitation, I will take Rumina's territory if she cedes it. Don't be so stupid, I'm not going to give it to you, so don't get too greedy. Degruel wanted to take over the land whenever he could, while Rumina's tried to stop him. So, some demon lords couldn't leave their territories. What's up with Guy? It doesn't matter because Ramirez is in my country, but you don't have any reason to defend this place, do you? I don't. I worry about Leon, so I think I'll go there and see him. Leon was the one I was most worried about, and he still hadn't been completely cleared. I was going to watch him because of this, so Guy's choice made sense. If that was true, I guess I didn't have to keep an eye on him anymore. Rimuru, you can afford it. Send some of your subordinates to Leon, Rumenas, Degruel, Milam, and these other places. When Guy asked me something out of the blue, I was very confused. In the end, I couldn't say no. I tried to stop him for a long time, but Guy wouldn't listen. He also wanted me to set up a magic transfer circle, so he could move quickly between each territory. It made me want to yell, "You're not my boss." I didn't do it because of one thing. To cut a long story short, I simply caved in to Guy. Because Guy's serious attitude made him seem so scary that it was hard to go against him. I probably could do it if I pushed myself, but I'd feel better if I just gave up. It was a measure that had to be taken, even if it wasn't necessary. But then, who are the right people to send and where should they go? Someone who could teleport and use telepathy net from anywhere, was strong enough to survive on their own if something bad happened, and was strong enough to resist being ruled over. The three demon females would be the ideal candidates in that situation. But Testarossa is already in charge of coordinating the Empire's affairs, so I don't think I can choose her this time. Carrera and Ultima are the most likely choices. After that, some of the executives would speak. First, Geld for Milam. Because they are familiar with one another and we need to resume construction, it will be accepted. He is popular with everyone. Oh, and Midley also wanted to meet with Gabel. He told him that he would like to train with him again. I see, that makes sense. Ultima was training Gabel, but after just a few days, he was already looking at me like he was about to cry. I might be able to give him a break by sending him over. In that case, Ultima would be included, and since we're still at war, the police weren't needed. If I needed to, I could call them back right away, so I think it would be fine to make the choice. Okay, after that, I'll send Geld, Gabel, and Ultima to Milam's territory. Sure, I'm excited about it. Milam's country was all set after this. Ruminas in the Holy Empire of Lubelius comes next. For Ruminas, do you have any preferences for who should be sent? I'm getting smarter. I figured I'd better ask her before I stepped on a landmine because she would be furious if I said I would send Veldora. I guess you're right. I'm glad you brought Sheehan with you today. She's been to my country before, so I'm familiar with her. Ruminas had said that Sheehan's violin was amazing. Not surprisingly, she remembered. I'll send Sheehan then. I'll also send you Adelman and his group. Ruminas was also someone Adelman knew. The seven heavenly saints seemed to have had a fight, but that was in the past, so they should be fine now. Since he's given me so much trouble, it might be fun for me to teach him something. I will take it, thank you. With this, Rumina's country was also all set. Who are you going to send to my country then? So, it could be anyone, since I don't know anyone. I'll send Carrera. Carrera? Yeah, talking about the yellow primordial, No way, you. Don't tell me you've been able to tame that one. Not really taming, or more accurately, it just happened. DeGruel, just accept it. I get where you're coming from, but now is not the time to talk about it. Ultima is the violet primordial, by the way. I was also shocked, so I know what you're going through. I had heard that Ultima, Ruminas, and DeGruel all lived in the same area, which means they must have known each other for a long time. I'm also in shock. Besides, yellow primordial and violet primordial aren't the only ones. You should know by now that it's a little late to talk about how stupid Rimuru is. Milam is agreeing by nodding her head, but I think she's probably on my side. Whatever. Okay, Carrera will go to DeGruel then, right? Wait, hold on a second. Objection. I also think I have the right to say no. The look on his face showed that he was desperate and determined not to give up. Leon, on the other hand, was smiling in a very calm way. He might as well have said, I'm glad Carrera didn't come to me. Listen, Rimuru, if you send that troublemaker to me, she'll destroy my Damerganya. I don't need much, but could you at least pick someone who is nicer? DeGruel said, character is more important than strength. Even if you say that, a lot of the people who work for me cause trouble. I asked him in detail what was going on. It looks like DeGruel's home country is a place of worship called the Holy Void, Damerganya, which is falling apart. It is a country with few resources and many buildings that have been destroyed by the sand. And DeGruel's idea of Carrera as a vandal who likes to shoot out nuclear magic as a hobby was the worst of all. DeGruel thinks that Carrera is worse than Milam's second name, the Destroyer. She's not so bad. She is. What DeGruel said is right. I've had to deal with her every day, so I can only imagine how you must feel. Then I think Carrera should go to Leon. Stop fooling around. Did you even hear what I said? I flat out refuse. That's the only demon I'll never let into my country. Rimuru, you can't send Carrera. Then why not? She constantly tries to fight me, but whenever she senses that she is going to lose, she simply throws the match and flees. This battle isn't a game. I don't want to waste my time or effort. You understand? If Carrera does exactly what you say and you take full responsibility for anything that goes wrong, I'll consider it. But that can't happen, right? You're right. Carrera-chan is trying to get. How many levels can you break through? To be a popular game in my labyrinth. It's really annoying, so I want you to stop. Such violence. It appears that some harm has been done without my knowledge, as was to be expected. I'm going to ask Diablo to have a look at this. Wahahaha. I liked Carrera and the others too. I'd like to meet her, so she's welcome to visit my country. Are you sure it's okay, Milam? Of course. So, the problem is now solved.